Okay, good afternoon, everyone. Okay, great. So I'm going to turn on my camera now. Okay, I'm set on the wrong camera. Sorry about that. Okay, can you guys see me now?
Yes, we can.
Yes.
Okay, great. All right, so I am here to speak about animation and design. Allow me to share my screen. Righty. All right, so let's get to this. Animation and design. All right, when we hear the term animation, cartoons come to mind, and you're exactly right. All right, animation and design. Here at Alpha Lewis, we're not only doing animation, but we're also doing design because we want you guys to be a well-rounded digital artist. This is the new trend these days. When you join our web development and our animation and design, all right, that we will get a well-rounded digital artist. So now I introduce myself as a course coordinator. My name is Ted Sandiford. All right. And what is animation and design? Animation and design is a balance of knowledge, computer software, and creativity skills to create animating graphics for an array of industries, including film, television, and marketing. Careers in animation and design would include. All right, this is a whole list. And I going through my going do my research on this, the list goes on and on. All right, we have the 3D modeler. I won't list all of them, but we have the 3D modeler, the animator, the art director. Okay, we have the flash animator, the graphic designer, stop motion. All right, we have the cartoonist. We have a director. Yes, you can also be a director. All right. We have the key animator. Oh, I think I have graphic design here twice. Okay. We have the texture artist. Okay. All of this will fall under digital media and media arts and animation. All right. Okay. What are your requirements for doing animation and design? You will need a grade one, two, or three in IT, that's information technology, and EDPM. Okay, you need a grade one, two, or three in principles of business and visual arts. Your portfolio is important because animation and design is very practical. Some people may have the know-how on how to do the animation and design or the art itself, right? But they need to show that they have the skill. They need to show that they can use their hands. They need to show that they have the creativity needed, okay, to handle the courses. All right. And I won't butter it up. All right. It takes a lot of work and it takes a lot of practice. All right. You spend many hours learning online. Well, we're doing it online for now, but you spend more hours practicing. And this is what animation and design entails, a lot of practicing. Because if you have to look at an anime, if you know the concept of animation, you would know that it's drawing several frames over and over and over to generate a movie, to generate motion. Okay? And many of you may not realize, but animation is itself, animation is a science. It's a science. If you go on ahead after you leave here to do a degree in animation, you would get it will be a bachelor or master of science. All right, because it's a science because it incorporates a lot of physics, lighting physics, all of that. All right, it's motion. All right, so these are your requirements for entering the class. All right, now the hardware required. All right, you need to have the correct tools. Yes, you need the creativity, but you need to have the tools so that you could be ahead of the game in the classroom. Okay, so you would need a PC or a Mac. all right, with a Intel or AMD processor with a 64-bit support, okay? 2 gigahertz processor or faster, all right? Memory, 2 gigabytes or more, and 8 gigabytes is recommended, okay? Go for the 8 gigabytes because the software that we're going to use, they will be taxing on your computer. If you could get 8 gigabytes or more, yes, the 2 gigabytes is recommended. But if you don't want to get frustrated, all right, with a slow PC, okay, I would recommend start from the 8 gigabytes. Okay. Like I mentioned, you need a fast processor. You need a lot of memory to withstand the work that you have to do. All right. You will need a digital camera. Notice I have this DSLR camera here, and then I also have phones. In this day and age, we have phones competing with cameras, okay? The majority of the students nowadays, they shoot their videos and whatnot with their phones. Because the quality that we get from the phones these days, if you have a phone from, let's just say, 2016 up, okay, you have a good camera on your phone. So we accept film use with your device, your mobile device, okay, your smartphone, or you could use your tablet. We have cameras on tablets as well, which are pretty good. All right. This tool here is very, very important, okay? This is your graphics tablet. This is what you will do your drawing on. You don't only do drawings on the graphic tablets. You can also edit photos, and you can also do 3D modeling on your graphics tablet, okay? Notice that I have two types of graphics tablets here. This one here, okay, this would be the tablet which doesn't have to have a screen. You connect it to the computer, and whatever you draw on the tablet itself, you will see on your monitor, right? The second one here, all right, you can act, it's an actual screen and a tablet at the same time. So you will be drawing, and you'll be seeing what you're drawing in real time. You won't have to be looking at the screen, the monitor like the previous one, okay? This tablet would be the cheaper version, and this one would be the more expensive version. Tablets range at different prices, okay? You have tablets starting from $25 all the way up to, I think the most expensive drawing tablet would be the Wacom Cintiq 32 inches, which is $3,700 with the stand. It's $3,200 without it, okay? So keep that in mind. But I'm sorry, I don't want to scare you with these exorbitant prices, but I'm also giving you the start off price. So you will get a good, decent graphics tablet without the screen for $25. Okay. All right. So these are the hardware requirements. Now, we have two levels here for animation and design. We have level one. That's the first year. The first year, you will be covering, Mr. Bissett already mentioned a few of them, so I won't repeat, all right, because time is limited, okay? He already covered the introduction to digital media. Yes, it's across the board, because this is the digital humanities. We need to do that introduction to digital media, all right? The fundamentals of graphic design, okay? This course will explore the process and concepts associated with digital imaging from conceptualization to output. Learners will apply sound principles of design and composition as they engage in the use of open source software. Open source meaning that you can actually get free software to do your graphic design on, software such as Krita and GIMP, okay? Okay, you can use your skills for purposes as web, television, print, or fabric. All right. Now, the reason why we're touching graphic design first is because what you learn in graphic design, you can implement it in your subjects down the line. For example, animation, okay, and audio visual. So graphic design and the principles of design would act as a foundation for the rest of them. Okay, don't think that graphic design is only posters and pictures. You use the same principles for your film, your audio visual, and your animation as well. Okay. You and the digital world, Mr. Bissett already covered that. All right. Introduction to marketing, right? Believe it or not, most of the animation, most animators, they make all their income by doing ads. Animators and designers, most of the income comes by doing ads. So that means we need to have a solid foundation in marketing. We need to know how to make products attractive so that we can sell these products. Okay. And we will be the magicians to do that. Yeah. They think we're magicians. All right. We are visual magicians. Okay. This course is designed to provide students with an understanding of the principles of marketing. There will be a focus on the management of the marketing activities and how marketing relates to overall organizational functioning, including the management of exchange processes between business units and consumers between firms. I stress on consumers because the consumer will be our audience. We are selling. All right. We are selling. All right. Making products look attractive. There is where the fun comes in. We have 2D animation, key concept, layout, and design. That's animation one. Okay. 2D animation. Okay. This course begins with a history of animation and explains the 12 principles of Disney animation. Learners will explore key processes of animation production and techniques used in creating animated characters. Okay. At the end of this course, learners are expected to apply to be able to apply basic drawing and animation techniques in the development of 2D animation. So you will be covering stuff, like I said, the 12 principles of animation. You will be doing the walk cycle. You will be doing frame by frame animation, where you start off with making a ball bounce, and then we develop from that. We're crawling first, and then we are going to fly with our animation. All right, so this would be animation. This would be animation one. All right. So, and 2D animation one. All right. So, writing for popular culture. Believe it or not, you need to know how to write properly. Okay. Writing is a form of communication. We need to know how to do that to communicate our, if we have to pitch our animation, we need to know how to write. And we need to know the trends. We need to know the upcoming trends or the present trends that's going on right now. So this is what writing for pop culture is all about. Okay. This course aims to introduce students to various aspects and different approaches to writing for popular culture, inclusive of writing articles, writing for advertising, marketing copy, and the web. This course exposes students to stylistic strategies applied by established writers in the industry and enables the development of effective approaches and techniques to developing their product for publication across different media types. Okay, so just imagine you can do your practical work, your drawings, your animation, and your designs, and you have this powerhouse of the skill of writing. Okay, this will make you a better, well-rounded creative. All right. Level two. That's in the second year of animation and design. Okay, we have 2D animation two, graphics and advertising. Now notice that word advertising, it is linked to marketing. So this is why we did marketing in the first year. So right now in this course, we are going to implement our marketing in our animation. Okay, this course is designed to expose learners to advanced techniques in animation production, such as the four-leg walk cycle, lip syncing, and voice acting. Okay, learners will engage in the development of animation to be integrated in ad and digital campaigns. They will also delve into the business components of animation. So this would be 2D animation too. Okay. Audio visual production. That's when we become directors. We are movie stars, you know, because audio visual, like it says, involves the use, okay, of your camera, your mics, and whatnot. Okay. This course covers aspects of digital audio visual audio video production for multimedia development. It provides in-depth understanding of theory as well as practical approach to audio video production in the digital environment. Okay, the key word here is practical. Before our pandemic, okay, the audio visual students will be all over the place getting footage. Okay, conducting interviews. We have to do documentaries. We have to do music videos. All right. So it is packed with practical work. All right. 3D animation. Now that will be your third set of animation. Okay. We will be using, okay, this course introduces students to all major features of industry software, Maya. Maya is the software used to create many 3D animated productions that we are used to seeing. Okay. We are going to delve into, we can't go into a lot of detail in that, but you will be introduced to modeling, animation, texture, lighting, rendering, expressions, rigging, dynamics, and the popular workflow. Students will gain proficiency by following class examples, as well as creating projects and exercises. The coursework is designed to make sure that the student is exposed to all relevant aspects of CG. Okay, CG meaning computer generated. All right, creations with Maya, with an eye towards giving the student a base foundation from which to explore and expand. The sky's the limit with the level of animation that you'll be able to do. All right, so digital marketing, the introduction to marketing is one thing. You need to advance into digital marketing now. All right. Digital marketing would basically be you using your digital tools for the marketing process. Okay. This course is designed to give learners an understanding of how to effectively incorporate digital marketing strategies into traditional marketing plans. Okay. Social media and web applications. Now, you are guys already familiar with social media. Right now, we are on basically a social media platform. We are on Zoom, and this is being aired on YouTube as well. So right now we're already in social media. Pick up your phone, social media, all right? So many of the social media platforms involve animation as well. So we need to know how to effectively produce artwork and designs for social media and the web. As you can see, this can actually be incorporated with web development as well. Okay. All right. Practicum 1 and 2 for animation. Okay. This is where I will actually go out there and create a product. Okay. You will actually create a product for a company. Product meaning a production, an ad for a particular company. You'll be placed into groups where you will work together, because production, animation, audio, visual, all of that is based on teamwork. In this industry, no man is an island. So here we are teaching you guys to work as a team. If you look at the ending of a movie, you'll see that the credits are going up at the end of the movie. These are several hundred thousands of names. All right. So we are teaching you here to work as a team. So you need to work in groups. So for some of the classes, group work is a must. Some of you may be frowning at that, but that's the reality of it. We are training you guys to go out there into the real world. And animation, probably design might pass, but animation, teamwork. All right. So this is what the practicum entails. You being ready. We're preparing you guys to go out there. We're preparing you guys to know how to write a resume. All right. To pitch a production. All this would be in your practicum. Notice you have practicum 1 and 2. The practicum 1 would entail the theoretical aspect of it. And practicum 2 will be you and your teammates working on your assignment for an actual business. It would be an actual job. Okay. Your general education courses, you can't run away from them. You can't run away from your general courses because they are very handy with you being a well-rounded animator and designer. Critical reading and writing, we have modern language, speech, okay, self and society, a survey of St. Lucian history and heritage. We need to know our history, okay? Mathematical reasoning and logic. Now, some of you all may frown at that, but the maths is important, okay? Ethics, very important. Ethics and professional development. We have science, design, and thinking. And lastly, we have, you can choose from your electives. There's a list of electives of every year. So you choose two electives, one first year and one second year. All right. So this would be the end of my presentation. Let me all right. So I am looking forward to answering your questions if you have any. All right. With this being said, thank you. This was my presentation.
So Alfred Lewis Community College, apply today and fast track your career.